Hello and welcome. Today we're doing a question from LeetCode. It's called Maximum Subsequence Score. This is a really fun problem, so let's jump right into it. You are given two zero indexed integer arrays, nums1 and nums2 of equal length n, and a positive integer k. You must choose a subsequence of indices from nums1 of length k. For the chosen indices, your score is defined as follows: the sum of the selected elements from nums1 multiplied by the minimum of the same selected indices from nums2. And we want to return that maximum possible score. So essentially, we are taking two numbers, say n1 and n2, and multiplying them together. N1 in this case is going to be the sum of some selected indices from nums1, and n2 is going to be the minimum of some selected indices from nums of 2. And the indices need to be of size k. So again, we want to return the maximum possible score, and a subsequence of indices of an array is a set that can be derived from the set of 0 to n minus 1 by deleting some or no elements. So example 1, we have nums1, nums2, and k being 3. We want to figure out what the maximum subsequence score would be. So taking a closer look at example 1, we have nums2 here, 1, 3, 3, 2, nums2 being 2, 1, 3, 4, k is 3, these are our indices. One possible way to solve this would be to just brute force it, right? Come up with all the possible subsequences we can of size 3 and figure out what their product should be, what their output should be. So if we were making all possible subsequences of size 3, how many would we make? We would have four possible subsequences. It would be index 0, 1, 2. It could be 0, 1, 3, 0, 2, 3 over here, or 1, 2, 3. This would be our last possible subsequence. Now, what is the subsequence score for all of them? Remember, for nums1, for those indices, we want to add them together. And for nums2, we want to find the minimum of those corresponding indices. So for the first one, 0, 1, 2, we're summing up 1, 3, 3. We get a total of 7. And we want to find the minimum between 2, 1, 3. So that would be 1 over here. So our subsequence would be coming from multiplying 7 by 1. Now for our next subsequence, we have 0, 1, 3. So we would be adding up 1, 3, 2, which gives us 6. And finding the minimum between 2, 1, and 4. We have a 1 here again. This is our minimum. It's going to be 1 for n2. This would give us 6. Then doing the same thing again for 0, 2, 3, we get 1, 3, 2. We want to add that up. We get 6. And then finding the minimum between 2, 3, and 4, which would be 2. Last one, we get 1, 2, 3. We're summing up 3, 3, 2, which puts us at 8. And the minimum between 1, 3, 4, again, if we have a 1, this is going to be 1 here. So our maximum output would come from these indices 0, 2, 3, and it's going to be 6 times 2, which is 12. So 12 is going to be our output. Now, if you notice, right, 1 is the minimum number in nums of 2. So anytime we included index 1, which had 3 for nums1 and 1 for nums2, n2 would always be 1. n2 equals the minimum of all the selected numbers in nums of 2. If we're including the minimum of the array, of course n2 is going to be 1. We can disregard all the other numbers. It doesn't matter whether we have a 4 or a 2 or a 3. If 1 is there, n2 will always be 1. Now, if that's the case, how do we maximize our subsequent score? Remember, we're multiplying two numbers, right? N1 and N2. If N2 is constant, the only way to increase our product would be to try to get N1 as high as possible. In order to get N1 as high as possible, it's just a sum of numbers. We want those individual numbers to be as great as possible. So if we are for sure picking index 1 that has 1 as nums2 and 3 as nums1, N2 will be set at 1. And of course, N1 will also be 3. But now we have two possibilities to add on for our n1, right? We're summing three numbers in total. So if 3 has to be here, we want to pick the next highest numbers, the next two highest numbers, to sum up for n1. So that's going to be 3 and 2 over here. So 1, 2, 3 would give us our best possible product if we are for sure including index 1. So 1, 2, 3, we saw that over here, right? We had 8 times 1 versus having 6 times 1 or 7 times 1. So 8 times 1 was the best maximum score we could have made with index 1. Now, what if we want to use 2 as our minimum? We know we need a subsequence of size 3, and in order to have 2 as a minimum, we need numbers that are higher than 2. We can pick anything, but they need to be higher than 2. Now, of course, the only other options are index 2 and 3. So summing that up, right, we get 1, 3, 2. that would sum up to 6, and 2, 3, 4 would have a minimum of 2, so this here would be 12. Now, what about 3 and 4? Can 3 be a minimum or 4 be a minimum? That's never going to happen. We need to have a subsequence size of 3, and they're not two more indices that have nums 2 higher than 3. And same with 4. We need two more indices that have nums 2 higher than 4. 4 is the highest nums of 2, so we'll never be able to use that as our N2. So essentially, we don't really need to make all possible subsequences. We just need to figure out what the best possible subsequence score would be for a given minimum in nums of 2. Now, if this is sort of coming together, the logic is forming, feel free to pause the video and give it a shot yourself before moving forward. Now, moving on to example 2, this is nums 2, k is 1. So here we can only make one pairing in our subsequence, right? It's just going to be the index pairings themselves. So taking index 0 and 0, we get 4 times 7, which is 28. Then we'll have 2 times 5, which is 10. 3 times 10, which is 30. 1 times 9 is 9. 1 times 6 is 6. The max here would be 3 times 10, which would be 30. Now, for example 2, say k wasn't 1, but it was 3 instead. So I have example 2 over here. I added an extra pairing, 13, 8, and k is 3. I want to find the maximum subsequence score I can make with all the possible minimums from nums of 2. Say I want to use 6 as my minimum. What would be my best subsequence? Well, what are all my options here? I need two more pairings that will have a nums 2 greater than 6. So I can use index 5, index 3, 2, and 0. Basically everything except index 1, because if we were to use this, the minimum would then go to 5. So with all of these available, we want to pick two that would give us our best product, and that's going to depend on nums of 1. So what two indices have the highest nums of 1? That's going to be 13, and it's going to be 4. And remember, we are only picking between 0 to 5, not including index 1. So between all of these, the best possible subsequence will come from index 5 and 0 if we had to pick index 4. So we're going to have 1 plus 13 plus 4. So with the minimum, with N2 being 6, our N1 is going to be 18. And we just want to do this for all the minimums, all the numbers we can make in nums of 2. So to code this up, say we are staying with this same example over here, what we can actually do is sort our pairs by nums of 2. Now we don't want to lose the corresponding values for a certain index in nums 1 and nums 2, so we can actually make tuples to pair them together. So pairs is going to be a list, and it's going to be a tuple of nums 1 of index I, followed by nums 2 of index I, for I in range length of nums 2. So pairs right now would look like the following. We have 4, 7, 2, 5, 3, 10, 1, 9, 1, 6, and 13, 8. We have our pairs together. Now we want to sort this based on nums 2 in decreasing order. So pairs.sort, and we're going to be passing in a key because we want to sort not by default on that very first index. So key is going to equal lambda x, and x is going to be index 1. And this needs to be in decreasing order, so reverse equals true. So pairs now looks like the following. It's sorted in decreasing order by what we had in nums of 2. So for N1 and N2 in pairs, we want to see what the best subsequence score would be for this given N2. Now, in order to do this, we need to initialize a couple things. First thing we're going to initialize is our max score overall, which is going to be 0, our current score, which is also 0, and we're also going to be initializing a heap. So this is going to be empty. For this, let's also import. So import heap q. And what we're going to do is maintain a heap for the values in nums of 1. So what does this actually look like? What are we doing here? What we're going to do is push n1 onto our heap. So heap q.heap push onto our heap n1. So heap right now is going to have n1, which is 3. And we want to update our current sum as well. So current sum plus equals n1, which means this is now 3. This is our first pair that we're adding in our subsequence. Now, unfortunately, we actually can't use 10 as our minimum in our subsequence. We need at least 3 pairings in there. So we're going to go back in our for loop and do the same thing for our new N1. So we're pushing 1 onto our heap and updating current sum by this value. So current sum is now 4. We still haven't hit k, so we're going to go back in this for loop and do the same thing again. So we're pushing 13 onto our heap and updating current score with that as well. So our heap currently stores 3, 1, 13, and the sum of that is 17. Now we do equal size 3, right? We have a subsequence of size 3. So what we want to do is figure out what this product is going to be. So if length of heap equals k, we have a subsequence we can make. We want to figure out what the product is. So that's just going to be current sum times the n2 that we are on, right? This was sorted in decreasing order. So every time we come across a new n2, this is going to be our minimum. So far we have a size of 3, which are these three indices right over here, these three pairings. We have 10, 9, and 8 in nums of 2. 8 is the minimum, so we're going to multiply our current sum by this minimum. So current sum times n2 is going to be our highest subsequence score using 8 as our minimum. We want to see if this is better than the max score we have so far. So max score is going to be the max of what we have in max score right now, and this new subsequence current score that we have with these three indices. So now we go back in our for loop again, and n1 and n2 are 4 and 7 respectively. We're going to push onto our heap n1, which is 4, and update current sum as well. So current sum is going to get an additional 4, which puts it at 21. Now we are greater than that subsequence size of k. So what do we want to do? If length of heap is greater than k, we want to remove the smallest number from our heap. Right now we have all of these that we can use, right? The minimum for sure is going to be 7. So we want to go with the highest value in nums1 that we will have, which means we want to pop off the smallest value from heap. We want to get rid of it. So what we're going to do, if length of heap is greater than k, pop from heap. And we're just going to subtract whatever we pop off from our current sum. So current sum minus equals heap q dot heap pop from heap. So right now the smallest value is 1, so we're just going to get rid of it. So popping it off and subtracting that from our current sum will put current sum to 20. So right now in our subsequence, essentially we have this pairing of 3, 10. We have this pairing of 4, 7. And we have this pairing of 13, 8. We got rid of 1, 9 because we know for sure 7 is going to be our minimum. So now we just want to take care of these numbers in our first index and pick the highest ones there. So now that we have exited this if condition, we are again a size of k, right? We're a size of 3. So we can go in this if condition. We want to see if we can update max score. So the max score will be the max of what we have so far, which is 136, and our current sum times n2. So, oh, actually, this should be current sum, not current score. Let me make these updates over here. These are all right. So our current sum right now is 20. 20 times 7 is 140. It is greater than our max score, so we're going to go ahead and update it. So our max score is now going to be 140. Going back in this for loop again, n1 is 1 and n2 is 6. We're going to push onto our heap this value over here. So we're pushing on 1, updating our current sum to be 21. Since we are greater than k, we want to pop off the smallest value, which is going to be this new thing that we added, right? So we're actually not going to be using this pair essentially because n2 is going to be smaller, but our sum is going to remain the same, right? We are going in decreasing order and we don't want to use 1. We're going to have a smaller sum with it. And we're also going to have a smaller n2 because of it. So we popped off the smallest value, subtracted that from current sum, and now length does equal k. So we figure out what the max would be. So current sum, which is 20 times 6, it's not going to be greater than what we have. It's going to be 120. So we don't really need to update max score. Going back in this for loop, we are now at 2 and 5, and we're going to run into the same problem over here, but let's just go through these lines. We're going to push onto our heap n1, which is 2. We're going to update current sum, so we're adding 2 over here. Since we are greater than that length of k, we want to remove the smallest one, which is our newest addition of n1. And we want to calculate what our max score could be. So our current sum, which is now 20, times n2, which is 5. So this is going to be 100. It's even smaller than what we had before. So of course, there are no updates that are needed. And now we actually finished going through everything in pairs. So now all we need to do is just return our max score. Let's go ahead and submit this. And it is accepted. Now talking about space and time complexity. For time, we do sort our nums1 and nums2 based on nums2. So this is going to be n log n. Then we iterate through our pair. So that's another O of n. And we also maintain a heap. To sort a heap, this is going to be n log k. our size of heap is going to be k. So overall, this puts us at n log n. So our time complexity is going to be n log n. And for space, we are maintaining a list size n1 plus n2. We know both n1 and n2 have the same size. Let's say it's n, so our space will also be O of n. And we just did a complete walkthrough with an example for our code. But if you have any questions, of course, let me know down in the comments below. I'll answer them. And if this video was helpful, like, comment, share, and subscribe. It really supports the channel. And as always, I will see you in the next one.